In 1991, a magnificent new motion picture premiered and enchanted the world. This spectacular model of storytelling combined the art of animation and a magical music score into an unprecedented achievement that won the hearts and minds of audiences, along with dozens of awards, including the coveted Oscar. But behind this story is another fascinating story. It originates where storytelling began and involves an engaging cast of characters, both ancient and contemporary, fictional and utterly human. It combines beautiful artwork, majestic words and music, and groundbreaking technology to tell a story as old as storytelling, and yet still a vital part of today. The story of Beauty and the Beast is an ancient one. It truly is a tale as old as time, with roots in legends from Greece, India, Africa, France, and Italy. After the success of Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs in 1937, Walt Disney was looking for stories to develop into feature-length films. One of these stories was Beauty and the Beast. But Beauty and the Beast proved a challenge to Disney's story team. So, although some work was attempted on the famous story in the 1930s and again in the 1950s, Walt returned Beauty and the Beast to the shelf, where it waited for rediscovery. In the late 1980s, Walt's nephew, Roy E. Disney, now executive vice president of the Walt Disney Company, had focused his attention on reinventing Disney animation for a new generation. The Little Mermaid had proved that Disney animation could be both true to its legacy of quality and communicate to contemporary audiences. What would the next step be? One of the ideas that kept coming back was Beauty and the Beast. Adapting Beauty and the Beast as an animated feature was a huge challenge for the Disney team. Many months were spent by a Disney artistic team based in London, but after an initial story reel was completed, all their work was abandoned. The story did not work. The Oscar-winning songwriting team of Howard Ashman and Alan Menken and producer Don Hahn remained on the Beauty and the Beast project to try again. Don Hahn brought directors Kirk Wise and Gary Trousdale, strong storymen who had never directed an animated feature before, to set a story team to work. Ashman and Menken began working hand in hand with the story team to create a sophisticated Broadway-style song score, creating music that propelled the plot and enhanced character development too. The original Beauty and the Beast story didn't offer the filmmakers much in the way of character development. There were only two major characters in the fairy tale. First, the story team searched for ways to enhance those characters. Although Belle is beautiful, the filmmakers felt she should be unaware of it. They made her a little eccentric. She reads, she's interested in stories, she's interested in adventure. And then she ends up in her very own fairy tale. The Beast needed to be defined next. Is he hero or villain? Victor or victim? The Beast is actually all of these. Creating new characters to expand and further the story was the next major step for the team. The tormented Beast is surrounded by a loyal group of household servants, also the victims of enchantment. They add warmth and comedy to a gloomy story. They also help guide the audience and give commentary to the story. What was needed now was a real villain, and the story team developed what had begun as a milquetoast fop into a complex villain named Gaston. If the Beast was ugly on the exterior and had a heart of gold, Gaston was handsome on the exterior and had the heart of a pig. As the plot thickens, he reveals his evil nature. Gaston will kill the Beast, not because he believes he's a monster, but because Beast is in the way of what Gaston wants. The story was strong. The characters were coming to life. A young team of artists had matured and grown into a new generation of great Disney animators. For their leading lady, Belle, they faced the challenge of creating a credible performance that broke with Disney tradition. Their goal with Belle was not to make her the most beautiful animated character ever done by Disney Studios. It was to communicate heart and soul. She is beautiful on the outside, but also beautiful from the inside. When it came to the Beast, they had to keep an inner life in the character. Their task was to draw a Beast who feels and experiences tremendous emotions which are evident in his eyes. He was surrounded with a cast of characters that could only be created through the art of animation. But creating motion and character for a candlestick was something like expecting an actor to perform with his shoelaces tied together. The solution was to focus on an impression of body movement. Here, for example, Lumiere kicks without having feet. Another way to make the objects come to life was through personality. Why did Cogsworth become a clock? The animators thought it was because Cogsworth craves order and promptness. Mrs. Potts is virtually nothing more than a head, so her performance was a complete triumph of facial animation. At one point, Mrs. Potts had to jump from the fireplace to the floor. Logic dictates that she would break, so the scene designers simply drew a pillow into the scene. Problem solved. Gaston presented another unique challenge. Believing that a comic figure could be a real menace required an expert animation performance. A whole young generation of animators who came to Disney in the early 1970s and mentored with Disney's old masters had learned their craft well. Beauty and the Beast premiered on November 13, 1991 to overwhelming critical praise and box office success. Beauty and the Beast brought Walt Disney feature animation back as a vital and credible art form. Just when things couldn't get any better for Beauty and the Beast, they did. The film won 3 Golden Globe Awards. An even more historic honor was near. Beauty and the Beast also became the first animated feature to ever be nominated for a Best Picture Academy Award, an honor that even Walt Disney himself never received. Most films are released to theaters, then to home video and television, where they end their life. Disney has always believed that these films have a life beyond their initial release, but with the advent of home video and now DVD, re-releases fell out of fashion. One day, years after the release of Beauty and the Beast, the producer and directors were at a meeting. The Star Wars Special Edition had come out. They began joking about how Disney should do that with its classic films. Everybody at the meeting laughed, but then, director Kurt Wise suggested doing just that to Beauty and the Beast. He suggested adding back a song called Human Again, which had been cut before the film's premiere. They all knew they'd hit on a big idea. The song had been removed because it created a story problem, a motif about time passing that didn't fit into the story. As this time was passing, what about Gaston? Where is Maurice? Is LeFou still on guard outside Belle's house? For the Broadway stage version of Beauty and the Beast, Alan Menken worked out the story problem by making slight alterations to the song, and the song delighted audiences. In addition, it helped to explain the point of view of all the household objects. Much of the original production team reassembled to create the new story and animation elements that would bring Human Again seamlessly into the film. The Little Mermaid had opened up a renaissance in Disney animation. Beauty and the Beast took that accomplishment and sent it soaring to a new level of acceptance and achievement. Many critics have hailed Beauty and the Beast as the Snow White of this generation of animators. The essence deep at the core of Beauty and the Beast is about the transforming power of love. Love does heal, and no matter what time we live in, that is an affirming message. Beauty and the Beast always says that.
Tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast.